My name is Cheyenne Antonio. I'm from Pueblo Puntado, New Mexico. And I'm here because I'm worried and I'm exhausted for continuously researching about fracking and trying to help any way I can with the community. I think one of the main aspects that's not being brought up is the health impacts and also the social impacts within this area. Because we can talk about water, we can talk about cultural resources, but if you look down on it, if you look really close at it, what about the health impacts? What about the social impacts? We had an explosion down here, and one of my relatives stated that he was scared. He's only a fifth grader. And what can you tell? How can you translate? For one, the brother here said, how can you translate fracking into Navajo? How can you translate methane in Navajo? How can you translate pollution in Navajo? Not only that, but violence that happens here. We don't have law enforcement. I am so surprised to see so much police here because we hardly ever see that. Like, I honestly feel like I'm being criminalized for standing on my own territory protecting my own land. And that is not right. That is not how we are as the Dene people. I don't feel safe with that many cops here. And so,
protecting all the white people that are here.
Yeah. And so please, like, look, respect our sovereignty. Respect where we come from. And really, like, if you want to help us, if you're thinking about scoping, look at the community. Look at our health impacts over here. We have people, we have been working on this. And we have been trying to get to our council delegate. We have been going to the tribe. We have been going to the feds. Where have they been? We have elders here who are worried and crying because they live right next to a drill bit and they can't sleep at night. Because they can't conduct their own ceremonies and prayers in the morning and at night because of that drill bit. And it's tiring. And the chemicals that are being used, we know the side effects. It's all over there. You can read about it. And then our ceremonies, what does that mean for us as Dene people? You know, our ceremonies come from this area. We have highly respected medicine, elderly people who are in this region. What is the BIA, what is BLM, what is Navajo Nation doing to protect us in that way? Our land is what defines us. And then also, when violence happens, where is the nearest substation at? I lost two family members and it took nearly 4 hours for anyone to come. And then it goes to social services. When someone is beaten in my family, where do they go? All of these border towns here are racist. They are racist. They don't respect us. So how if we're thinking of scoping, where do you want to scope at? Because life as an Indian, life as a Dene person, we are constantly being targeted for this color of our skin. And so please, you know, get the health impact ready because we have been doing that. Get the environmental impact because we have been doing that. There's a methane cloud right above us. And why are we constantly drill? No. We can't do that no more. We have to think of our kids. I can't have kids now because of all this pollution. I'm the youngest generation from my great-grandmother. Oh, there's my 4 minutes. But yeah, if you want to scope culturally, scope environmentally, scope through social impacts, and then you'll see exactly where we're at and why we stand with our people, why we stand with the land. No more. Thank you.